This song is called Why by Rima. Hi, Chili Pilly. Being on here anymore. It's so sad because I used to love going on live. I hate it. I'm trying to be on live right now. That sucks because I used to need to go on live. I used to feel like I needed daily.
I know that you're drunk.
I don't know. I just don't like it. It hurts. I don't want to go. I want to enjoy my time. It's not that bad. It's not that bad. It's just weird when you haven't been on live in a long time. Leave my fucking edges alone. Can we not? Why aren't we fully just adjusted to this? Why haven't we just learned to accept the inevitable truth? What's wrong with my necklace? Oh, wait. I don't want to talk about it. I really don't want to talk about my edges. Leave me alone. I have a hairstylist. That's so crazy to me. Because you guys expect day in, fucking day out, every moment of my life, any time that you see me, that my edges are going to be perfectly swooped and scooped. That's not gonna happen. It's not. Hi, Dante. It's not gonna happen. It's not possible. It's impossible. So stop. Stop it. My dot is my mole. I got one here. And I got one here. And then I got one here. See it? You see it? And then I got one here. See it? Jesus Christ. My titties looked good like 5 minutes ago. I don't know what the fuck's going on now. Leave my edges alone. And it's only the right side. And that's because I put makeup on. And then the makeup builds up around the edges because the glue that's just peeking out just a tiny bit to blend it, it's a tiny bit sticky, so the bronzer or the contour just sticks to it. God, learn something. Learn from this. No, no tattoos for me. I don't even think. Maybe. I mean, maybe. Maybe one, something tiny. Like a really. like a really small Nicki Minaj right on my titty. I should get Nicki Minaj tatted on my titty, but she's like this. And but it's so small and it's like that big. Right there. And she's going like this. Or no, no, even better, even better, even better. Who? NLE Choppa going like this. I should get NLE Choppa tatted on my titty just going like this. Or like this. Like that. That would be hard. That would be tough. That's a dope pose. Hold on. That's such a sick pose to do. Does anyone else do this anymore? Does anyone pose like this? Hi, MTV. My birthday was cool, but look at this pose. Wait, does anyone else pose like this anymore? Or like, what's another one? Ooh, like an up against the wall kind of vibe. Like this. That would be sick. I wish people pose like that more. That's fucking hard. God damn it. Ah, fuck. Clifton, stop. I love the foot on the wall vibe. Like this. Nah, hold on. That's a sick pose. It's just like, fuck your feelings. Like, fuck what you think. That's what that pose says to me. And you know what that post says to me? It says, I got unfinished business. You know what I love doing? When I'm not doing shit, I like to, you guys heard of found flicks? Is anybody, okay, here's a better question. Is anybody in here afraid of scary movies? Anybody in here who cannot watch scary movies? Because you don't want to see blood or fucking, I don't know, ghosts and shit. No new friends. Sorry, I saw somebody comment about that. No, but you got anybody? Yes? Couple? Probably. There's probably hella people in here who can't watch scary movies. I'm one of those people. So I go on YouTube, and there's this guy on YouTube called Found Flicks, and he does explanations of scary movies, and he doesn't just do scary movies, I don't think. Or maybe he does. But he'll do explanation. It's called, like, whatever movie you want to see. Orphan Explained or whatever. And he'll go through the entire movie with, like, still frames of it. So you see a little bit of shit and you might get unlucky. Because I saw somebody, like, some pretty gory shit today by accident. Because he put some of the stuff in the thing. But you can just scroll down. You don't have to see any of the scary stuff. And he'll read through the whole, like, everything. Every scene. It's fire. Found Flicks is fire. We support Found Flicks. Huh? Some... Thanks, Lele Pons. That's hard. Lele Pons is in my fucking live. Lele Pons, what do you think of this pose? What do you think of it? Thanks. I can't stop listening to Fire and Desire. Since I've put this live on, I have been trying not to play Fire and Desire because I cannot stop playing it. And I feel like it's unhealthy to listen to the same song all the time because then it gets played out. And I remember loving this song. And not the original Fire and Desire, the Drake Fire and Desire. I did just listen to the Rick James version or the original.
Halloween. I had a Halloween plan. All right, fuck my idea. What are y'all gonna be for Halloween? What's everybody in here gonna be for Halloween? And then I'll tell you. You have to tell me first. For you, Clifton. You should be me for Halloween. No, because I'm not telling you what I'm gonna be for Halloween until you tell me what you're gonna be. How do people know about motive? Is it out? What is going on? What is going on? Hold on. Scratch that last conversation. I'm coming back to it. How the Go back to your room. How are you? How do you know this? This ain't even the audio. It's a scam. How do y'all know? How do y'all know? How do y'all know? How do y'all know? Oh, she posted the track list. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. I didn't even know that. Okay, cool. Fire. Yeah. So, about that. You guys excited? 6 hours ago? Oh shit. What a pleasant surprise. I didn't get a text, but that's pretty fucking cool. I'm glad you guys know now. It's coming out. I would play it in celebration right now, but I'm not doing that. At all. Not an amount of ponies and money that you could give me to do that. So, y'all just gonna have to wait. I'm playing Fire and Desire. You're gonna be Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton for Halloween. All right, cool. All right. You should be like Donald Trump in like stilettos or something. I don't know. Jessica Rabbit is fire. Sailor Moon is a good costume. Nicki Minaj is a good costume. Nobody's telling me their costumes. Y'all shy? My costume is crazy. I feel like I should just spoil it. But I can't, but I won't. I'm not doing that. I'm not spoiling. Stripper Trump is fire. Betty Boop is a cute costume. I would be that. I would be her. She's cute. You're gonna be a cucaracha. I know somebody's gonna take my idea, that's why I won't say it. I mean, you say that like it's easy. Wednesday Addams is hot. That's a child. Why did I just say that? I mean, as a costume. I don't know, man. Adults dress up as like anybody. You got like Dora the Explorer and shit. I mean, if I dressed up as Wednesday Addams, I would try to look good. I get it. What the fuck? Damn it. Whatever, anyway. Elvira is fire. I almost was gonna be Elvira, but I have a costume. So my costume is the same person, but in many different times. I'm gonna be the same person, but it's different occasions. It's hard because it's a she. She's wearing very specific things in some of them. And they're the easiest costumes until I get to like the outfit. I need a pajama, so y'all aren't gonna know. But I need a, you might know. If you could find out who I'm gonna be for Halloween through this, then kudos to you. I need a pajama set. I need a camisole. Camisole. How do you say that? Camisole. Camisole set. Where it's a little like, you know, camisole. But it's yellow here. And then silk baby blue. And then a little baby blue pant. In silk. And then I need a tub of Vaseline. I need a tub of Vaseline. And then I need to get the right wig for it. But that's my costume. Don't fucking play with me. If you find out who it is, great, good for you. But if somebody steals my costume, I'm coming for you. I'm gonna beat the shit out of you. I'm gonna beat your ass with my bare hands. If you could find out who I'm gonna be for Halloween, I'll give you like $2. I'm gonna be the same person on 3 different occasions. You know what? On that note, I need to call somebody. I'm just gonna go. I love you guys. I'm gonna go. I need to make some calls. That's the thing is, you guys are too young to know. I really thought the tub of Vaseline would give it away. But I need a tub of Vaseline and maybe just a big sack of Vaseline. And just hold it like this. And then I have my pajamas. No makeup. Thoroughly moisturized. You should know who that is. But then again, you shouldn't because you guys are young. But it's not that long ago. It was an iconic moment in history, in TV history. You should know, but anyway, I'm gonna go. Damn, my costume's about to hit. Jesus Christ. All right, bye. Love you guys. You don't know. You don't know. You know nothing.